An improbable comeback is complete. Oregon State in overtime ends a 13-game conference losing streak. 22 consecutive road losses. That streak comes to an end. 41-34, the Beavers win it after trailing 31-3 early in the third quarter, and KD Nixon stepped up as the star in place of LaVisca Chenault.
He was sensational throughout the game, especially in the first half. Two touchdowns, a career high. 132 yards, a career high for game numbers, all in the first half for Nixon. So the passing attack, while LaVisca Chenault would have added to it, KD Nixon held up. But then in the second half, they put Jake Luton on the field, and the Beavs passing offense became a thing of beauty. He was able to get the ball out of his hands on time. He and Isaiah Hodgins continued to hook up over and over again. Trey Udofia had no answer. The entire Buffalo secondary had no idea what to do once Jake Luton came out there. And then, as the game neared, cold, crushed depth, the offense needed a touchdown. Jack Coletto, who started the game, his first career start, got them into the end zone, and the much maligned Oregon State defense, all the numbers indicate they've been amongst the worst in the country all season. They made the plays that needed to be made when they needed to make them, snatching victory from the jaws of defeat.
And a devastating loss for the Buffs, who have lost three in a row after starting the season 5-0. And a beat-up Oregon State team comes to Boulder in an amazing comeback from down 31-3. Jake Luton did all of that after halftime. Jermar Jefferson, his fifth 100-yard game of the season, went over 1,000 yards on the season, and Isaiah Hodgins, a huge day as well. For Anthony Herron, Roxy Bernstein from Folsom Field in overtime, 41-34 Oregon State with the shot.